పెద్దలు కేంద్ర మంత్రివర్యులు పురంధేశ్వరి గారికి అలాగే శాసనసభ్యులు మిత్రులు గాండ్ర వెంకటరమణారెడ్డి గారికి I feel incredibly honored actually to get this kind of a felicitation by none less than Purandeswari garu. There are a couple of reasons why I feel I'm very privileged and proud to be here. First reason obviously is the fact that I represent India. I'm proud to be an Indian, and I'm proud that I'm part of a young India which is fearless, which is energetic, which is looking forward to progress like never before. I'm also proud to represent an India which wants to continue the traditions and culture and remember the sacrifices of our great forefathers who have done so much for the freedom of our country. And I think, in a way, I really feel proud to be associated with NATS. That's the reason why I'm here. For most of us who are sitting here, we all have come from humble backgrounds. We are incredibly lucky to be here because our parents didn't have this opportunity. Most of the families have grown up in rural India, an India which still contributes to 65% of the Indian economy. And I think this is a time when the whole world is looking at us and we need to draw inspiration from so many of you working so hard here in such a professional manner. I have been associated with Ravi Garu and Madhu Garu from a long time. I was also part of the progress when NATS was being formed. To actually live up to what you plan to do is not an easy task. And both of them have supported and stood by so many families in terms of distress. There have been times when I have received emails at incredibly late hours requesting the support of the government and the officials there in helping an Indian student or his family. NATS has always stood by and supported those great causes, and I feel so proud to be associated with an organization that does service totally in a selfless manner. Today, Andhra Pradesh is growing as an investment destination. Despite the many ups and downs that we see of the climate with regard to the politics or the many issues that we all are seeing today, I still believe that the state has tremendous potential. We are number three in the country in terms of growth. Our GSDP is better than the national average. There are so many of young entrepreneurs who have come up and made Andhra Pradesh proud. The moment you land at Shamshabad Airport, you realize that Andhra Pradesh has changed. The state has an incredible future. It has a coastline which no other state can boast of. It's got investments in infrastructure, education, and most importantly, in the way we deal with a business climate. Just before I made this trip, I had a meeting with different political party leaders from the TRS, from the BJP, from the TDP, from the communist parties, and also the members of the Congress party. Every one of them wanted me to reassure the audience here that they will always stand by the business community, promote harmony, ensure that there is good investment climate in Andhra Pradesh, irrespective of their own individual agendas with regard to certain issues which are pending in Andhra Pradesh. All I can say is, here is an India which is very vibrant. Here is an India which wants to move forward. And here is an India which all of us should feel proud about. I don't think this afternoon I was sharing the dais in a business seminar organized by NATS. And you should see the way, obviously they have been citizens of this country, individuals who can influence almost up to $1 billion of investment. They are all very strong and supportive of the fact that India is going to be a big superpower. We are no longer just an IT powerhouse. We have moved away from being an IT and ITES oriented, sector oriented industry growth to manufacturing, to ports, to infrastructure, to pharmacy. We are stepping out and making sure that all of us have a climate where each one of us can participate in industrial investment. And I think that is the opportunity that all of you should grab. On behalf of the government of Andhra Pradesh and the fact that I happen to be the speaker of Andhra Pradesh Legislative Assembly today, I can very strongly reassure you that all of us will stand by you in terms of your commitment, in terms of your investment in Andhra Pradesh, and we'll always be there to walk along with you in this progress that we all want to do. Once again, I'm so privileged and grateful to both Ravi Garu, Madhu Garu, and their incredible team that has worked so hard to make this program a reality. It is never an easy proposition to make an event so successful. So to all of you who are behind the curtain and in front of the curtain who have done this program, thank you so much. And to all of you once again, God bless. Thanks a lot.